Good morning, children. Welcome to the class. How are you all? Hope you all are good. Okay. Now we'll start the class. Okay. See, yesterday in previous class we have learned about why different places on Earth experiences day and nights differently. Why? Can anyone answer? Why different places on Earth experience the sunrise and sunset differently? Yes, very good. Because the Earth rotates from west to east, and while it is rotating, the easternmost parts of the Earth experiences the sunlight first, and the other side later. Okay, which countries experience the sunlight first? Already I have told you. Which countries? Very good. Japan and Australia experiences the sunlight first. Why? Because they are in the easternmost part of the Earth, and later India and other Asian countries. And North America and South America, they both experience the sunlight very later. Okay. Now, coming to the point of today's, we can see that heat from the sun is not equally distributed across the surface of the Earth. See, we can see that, we can observe that, not we can see, no, we can see how, observe this picture first. Okay. Observe this picture. Sun is not spreading its rays. Distributing the sunlight equally to every part. Why? Which place experiences the sunlight first? A or B? Sorry, A or B? Which place? A. Very good. Because why? This is because Earth is tilted on its axis and its surface is curved. Because Earth is tilted, tilted means it will move. It will move by itself and it is curved. So, first A part will be experiencing the heat first. Okay? Very good. Now, when Earth orbits the Sun, the Sun's rays fall directly on the area around the equator. When Earth orbits the Sun, okay, when this is the Sun and this is the, when Earth orbits the Sun rays fall directly near the equator. Which countries are there near the equator? Directly the sun rays fall on that countries, okay? Making it the hottest as it is closest to the sun. Why? See, it is very hottest places which are near the equator. Which countries are near the equator? They are very hottest because the sun rays falls directly on the which are there near the equator. That is why the places in this area are very hot. Now only I told you. That's why the places near the equator are very hot. Okay? The sun's rays do not fall directly as we go away from the equator. The sun's rays do not fall directly. See, this is the equator. This is very, if we go far from the equator, the sun's light does not fall directly, okay, towards the poles. So it is coldest at the poles, okay, poles. The sun rays directly not on the poles. So, poles are coldest places. Okay? Next. See, observe. Observe this. Okay? See, to understand the distribution of heat better, Earth is divided into three different heat zones. For our sake, for understanding, the Earth is divided into three heat zones. How many heat zones? Three heat zones. What are they? Can anyone answer? Yes, they are. What are they? They are torrid zone or tropical zone. Torrid zone, temperate zone and freezed zone. Okay, what are they? They are torrid zone or tropical zone, temperate zone and freezed zone. Okay, freezed zone means latitudes and longitudes. We have 66 degrees north latitude is freezed zone, and temperate zone 23.5 degrees north, the upper part of the earth, and the lower part of the earth same as south temperate zone 23.5 degrees south and 1/4 degrees north, freezed zone. Okay, now torrid zone or freezed zone, the hottest zone on which the sun's rays fall directly. Torrid zone or freezed zone. See, temperate zone, torrid zone on north, and the south side south side also same, torrid zone, temperate zone and freezed zone. This is equator, means 0 degrees. Freezed zone 66 1/4 degrees, and temperate zone 23.5 degrees. Same here also, 23 north, and this also north. See, 23 degrees half south and 60 degrees south. Sorry, not 60 degrees. 66 1/4 degrees south. Okay. Now, the hottest zone on which directly sun falls. Torrid zone means the hottest zone which sun rises falls directly. And extends from Tropic of Cancer in the north to the Tropic of Capricorn in south. This torrid zone is extends from Tropic of Cancer north to Tropic of Capricorn south. Okay, and temperate zone the moderate temperature zone on which the sun's rays do not fall directly. See, this is temperate zone. The moderate temperature means not so much high. In middle, okay? See, the sun's rays does not fall directly here. And extends from the Tropic of Cancer to the Arctic Circle in north. See, extends from the Tropic of Cancer to the north. To Arctic Circle. And same here, it extends from the Tropic of Capricorn to Antarctic Circle. Now, freeze zone. The coldest zone where the sun shines only for 6 months. This is freeze zone. Only the sun shines for 6 months. Only 6 months. Okay. It extends from the Arctic Circle to Arctic Circle in the North Pole. It extends from Arctic Circle to North Pole. From Arctic Circle to North Pole. And here from Antarctic Circle to South Pole. Well, okay. This is our class for today. Thank you. Bye.